Hello, and welcome to this video on the review process in Zoho CRM. As different businesses attempt to vet the data that enters into their CRM system, Zoho CRM allows businesses to do just that. With a proper review process in place, you can control records with invalid data from entering the CRM database, which helps the sales reps close in on the deal with the right information at hand. Consider Zilker University. They offer multiple courses in different cities and receive hundreds of applications for each city through their website. Their office administrators process them, and they are either accepted or rejected. While submitting an application, the student has to enter information like student name, email, percentage, GPA, and upload relevant documents that support their application form. The review process in Zoho CRM allows field-by-field review before you can add them as a record. You can choose the set of fields that have to be reviewed and validate them based on your business requirements. Say Zilker University only considers students who have scored a GPA of 2 or more. For all the students who fall in that category, the fields mentioned above have to be reviewed before their application is accepted, i.e., before the record is accepted as a valid record in their CRM account. Let's see how this is done. Go to Setup, Process Management, Review Process. We create a new process. Now, let's provide the relevant information, like process name, which in this case would be application review. Description of the process goes here. Choose the module and the layout for which the review process is configured. For the case of Zilker University, let's choose Student Applications module and the standard layout. Now that that's set, we move on to the main criteria, which in this case would be the student's GPA of 2 or more. Based on your business process, you can add up to 25 criteria as required. We can see the review process configuration screen. Once the main criteria is set, we select the set of fields that are to be reviewed. Here, these fields are student name, email, percentage, GPA, and supporting documents fields. After that, we can select sub-criteria apart from the main criteria to choose who can review the fields. Say, for example, students from Texas can be reviewed by a certain administrator, and students from New York can be reviewed by someone else. When you select the sub-criteria, you have to configure the reviewer for the students who are not a part of the above sub-criteria. In Zilker's case, let's choose all records for sub-criteria. Once that's done, we configure the instant actions that are to be executed once the review is completed. You can select any of the following. Notification on submission action will notify the users whenever a new application is submitted and it's added as a record in the CRM account. Send notification on review completion option sends a notification to the users once the review is completed. Send notification on rejection option will trigger a notification to users once an application is rejected. SLA escalation option will allow users to escalate when a review is not completed within a certain time frame. You can choose the number of days here and the reviewers to whom the matter is escalated. For Zilker's case, we select all of them and set the number of days as 7. Reviewers to whom the matter is escalated are Martha Hills and Pooja Raman, who are the Dean of Admissions and Admissions Coordinators. As a next step, you can configure your own reasons for rejecting a particular record. These can act as templates that can be used quickly at the time of review. Click on Configure Reasons for Record Rejection and add them. Here, let's add invalid documents, wrong calculation of percentage, and insufficient documentation. Click Save to save the review process. Let's see how this works. This is one of the applications that were submitted. Click on this icon next to the percentage field. Comment and approve or reject that field. Same goes for the GPA field, the email field, the student name field, and the supporting documents, which is a file upload field. Note that even if one of the fields are not approved, the entire record is not approved. Also, only when a record is accepted or rejected, it can be edited. Until then, records in the review process cannot be edited. Also, the number of fields that are reviewed count is displayed here at the top right corner of the screen. All of the records under review process are listed under My Jobs. Whenever a review process is disabled, the records under that review process can be rejected or moved to the system, or it can be moved out of that process and moved into a different process. If we choose this option, and if there are any other review process that has the same criteria, then the records will be moved to that process. Apart from this, you can check the review analytics from this tab. Here, you can see the review status history, the field status history, the reason for rejection history, and the average waiting time by review process. Note that review process can be configured only for the newly created records, and it cannot be applicable to the existing records. Review process precedes all automation and process management features in our CRM, i.e., records under review will not go through other features like workflow rules, blueprint, or orchestration. We also have an option to view the records under review by choosing the student applications in review view from the dropdown here in different modules. That's all about the review process in Zoho CRM. For more resources on Zoho CRM, visit zoho.com/crm/resources.